Would you like to be a millionaire? If so, this video is for you. Today, we will show you the 8 habits of millionaires. If you adopt at least 3 of these 8 habits, you too could become rich. Could these habits be the difference that sets millionaires apart from those who have no money at all? Have you ever noticed that millionaires or billionaires worldwide have very similar characteristics and behaviors? But what do these people have in common that enables them to achieve such grand results? Is it possible for ordinary people to achieve such results? Well, the truth is, they are all ordinary people, and most of them came from very different backgrounds than the ones they live in today. What we should do is model these behaviors, adapt them to our reality, and pursue their results. Embark now on this journey towards excellence. You wouldn't want to miss out. So if you want to be rich, comment like this: I copy the habits of the rich. Just comment that: I copy the habits of the rich. When I see this comment, I'll give it a heart, because I know you will achieve everything you aim for in your life. Now that you've commented, let's continue. First of all, I'd like you to think about something. How different would your life be if you simply didn't give up on what you gave up years ago? How different would your life be now? Today, we'll talk about the 8 things that successful people do and unsuccessful people don't. I strongly believe that you don't need to reinvent the wheel. You don't need to create a new model for success, because what works has already been written. What you need is to know how to model those who have succeeded. If someone has done it, you can do it too. And the first time this caught my attention was when I was younger and read a book called Think and Grow Rich. I realized that no matter where I was born, what my circumstances were, what matters is that I put the right pieces in place to create the life of wealth I've always dreamed of. And if I do that, I'll end up getting what I want. But since we're talking about success, what is success for you? Success is something very relative. It can mean something different for you than for me. It can mean joy, peace, happiness, a large family, cars, trips, clothes, freedom. Whatever it is, it's different for each person. But when I look at everything in life, I realize that each thing in life has steps to be successful. Success can mean many different things to different people, but I'll go over 8 different things I've seen in people who have succeeded in their lives. Success for me is having maximum freedom, freedom to do whatever I want, whenever I want, with whomever I want, without worrying about money, and not having to give up something or buy something for lack of money. That's success for me and for you. What is success for you? The first thing I find in many successful people, not all of them, but 80% of them, is the habit of waking up early, not just once or occasionally, but consistently waking up early every day and having some kind of morning routine. So, when I was researching this, I thought, let me see here, what time do successful people wake up? And then I found people like Richard Branson, who is a multimillionaire, wakes up at 4:30 every morning. Tim Cook, who is a multimillionaire, wakes up at 4:30 every morning. Howard Schultz, who is the guy who started Starbucks, wakes up at 5 o'clock every morning. I'm not saying you have to wake up at these times, but the reason they wake up at these times is that they have time for themselves. Whether it's for reading, journaling, exercising, they have time to be intentional, to become who they want to be. They follow a routine, they do this before going to work. They have thousands of employees and yet wake up early every day to have more time for themselves in the early hours of the day. They take care of themselves. Have you been taking any time to take care of yourself? Imagine if you could try this and wake up at least an hour earlier and spend that hour with yourself instead of watching Netflix or watching sports. If you cut that hour at night, go to bed an hour earlier, wake up an hour earlier and spend some time with yourself, how would that be for you? So ask yourself, do you feel like you wake up early enough now to have a specifically dedicated time for yourself and your own development? If the answer is no, I would recommend incorporating this into your life. When you wake up early, you have peace. No one bothers you at that time, because the people who complain all day long are all asleep at that time. Even the air is purer at that time. The atmosphere is lighter because there's no one complaining about life at that time. There's no one swearing. Everything is peaceful. But when 7 o'clock comes, the atmosphere already changes. By that time, there are already people complaining about life again. The air is polluted again, and everything bad starts happening again. Isn't that terrible? Experience this for at least 7 days and carefully observe these points I just mentioned, and you'll see that I'm right. The second thing I found really interesting is that millionaire people read almost every day. There's an article that came out a few years ago saying that an average CEO reads about 60 books a year. 60 books a year, which means the average CEO, who is at the top of their company, the highest in their industry, reads 60 books a year. That's more than one book per week. So you have to ask yourself, how many books am I reading? How much am I really trying to learn? How much am I really trying to grow? And try to learn from some of the most successful people who have ever existed. The beauty of life is that everything you want to learn about anything, from self-development to high mastery, from religion and spirituality, and especially about wealth, all these things, all the books have already been written that you could want to read from some of the smartest people who have ever existed. Why don't you just start reading these books? How often do you read? And if you set a goal for how many books you would like to read per month, find out that number, write it down, and start following it. The third thing they do is exercise consistently. They understand that there is a mind-body connection. If your body is not in the right place, there's a good chance your mind isn't either. Your mind and your body have a constant connection at all times. A good example of this is if you eat something very heavy in the middle of the day, you feel very tired after lunch. Have you ever experienced this? Do you know that feeling of being in the middle of the day and feeling very tired and immediately craving coffee? And this may not be a natural feeling. Perhaps it's because you're eating something that's making you feel that way. And when I say they exercise consistently, it's because they understand that when you exercise consistently in the morning or at night, whatever it may be, your body will start to create more energy throughout the day. And the more energy you have throughout the day, the more energy you'll have to accomplish your goals, whatever they may be. So one of the things they do consistently is work out 4 times a week, and they're always on the move. How many times a week do you exercise? Leave your comment there. The fourth thing is to consistently write down your goals. Also in the 70s, Harvard did a study on people who were graduating from Harvard with an MBA. From that graduating class, only 3% of them actually wrote down their goals. And then 10 years later, in the 1980s, they followed up with all these people and found that the 3% who wrote down their goals with pen and paper were 10 times more successful than all the other 97% combined. So 3% of the people who wrote down their goals were 10 times more successful than the other 97%. The truth is, it becomes real when you write it down with pen and paper. It becomes physical in this world. It becomes something you see and something you can work on. And often, people set goals and never write them down, and it never works. They will never work on their goals to figure out how to achieve them, which is really the biggest obstacle for people not achieving their goals. But the example I would like to give is like if I gave you a multiplication problem. Look at this example. Do you know how to do the math in your head? 129 times 47. Most people listening now wouldn't be able to do that in their head. But if I give you a piece of paper and a pen and tell you exactly the same number, you could figure it out by doing the multiplication you learned in the 4th grade or the 3rd grade. So when you can take something out of your head and put it on a piece of paper and start working with it, this process makes things that are difficult much easier to achieve. When you consistently write down your goals every day and work with them the same way you would build a business plan. When you're going to make a business plan, you don't do it in your head, you write everything down. When you practice this process, you begin to have more clarity about exactly what you want. Ask yourself, how often do you write down your goals? And if it's not often, maybe you should just develop the practice of writing down your goals every day and working with them every day, making it part of your journaling practice. Comment like this: from today on, I write down my goals. The fifth thing millionaires do is have mentors. I read an article years ago that said the person who becomes a millionaire on average has 7 mentors before becoming a millionaire. So if you're out there and you're looking around and you think, I don't have a mentor, the reason why this is important is because they can shorten your learning curve. Condense 20 years of knowledge and experience into 2 years for you. That's the importance of hiring a coach. A mentor is someone who is further ahead in the process than you, who has already done what you want to do and has already made the mistakes you will eventually make. If you just learn from them, you can shorten your learning curve, not have to go through their mistakes, and at the same time, see exactly what you need to do to get where you want to go. I have a friend I recently made friends with, and she runs a business in the same industry as mine, but hers grosses 50 million a year, and mine grosses 5 million a year. She's light years ahead of me. What does she know that I don't? How can I learn from her? What does she do that I don't yet? How can I bring the value she has in her business to my business? How can we help each other? It's fantastic when you start adhering to this new habit. You start taking a shortcut to where you want to go because you're connecting with people who already have the keys to it. When you start getting mentors, find out what it is to be able to help someone who is further along in the process than you, and also be helped by someone who is further along in the process than you. There are 2 different types of mentors that I always talk about. Number 1 is paid and number 2 is free, and you can find out which one is best for you. I have many friends who are great mentors of mine, and I don't pay them anything. We have meetings and help each other mutually. They are free mentors, but they don't feel obligated to make me successful. They want me to succeed, but there's no obligation on their part for me to succeed. But I've had mentors who were paid. And when you pay someone, there's more of a sense of obligation and there's a more consistent meeting process. I'm always with my mentors every week. They have a certain obligation for my success to happen because I'm paying them. Of course, I need to be 100% dedicated to that success. You can have a paid or free mentor, but the important thing is to have someone who can guide you and give you the keys to open the doors you need to get where you want to go. The sixth habit I always find in these people is positive self-talk. We're all born positive people, but the world kind of destroys that within us, and we have to refine that positivity. You're not going to wake up every day super excited to face the day, but how can you start talking to yourself in a way that motivates you to start moving forward and taking action more? How can you start speaking and empowering yourself? I want you to understand that it's hard to succeed in this world. It's even harder when you have someone constantly talking in your ear. You have your own self talking in your mind all the time. How can you build a system of positive self-talk to be more intentional with all the conversation you have inside your own head? I'll give you an example of an experiment we did. We took a container and filled it with soil, a lot of dirt. Then, we took a glass of water and poured it into this container. The truth is, nothing changed. But if you take a garden hose and put that garden hose and it's flowing and flowing constantly, eventually the garden hose will move so much water that it will end up removing all the dirt. That dirt equals all the negative thoughts inside your head. It's not about thinking positive sometimes or having a few positive thoughts. You will have to brainwash yourself to be positive all day, every day. When I realize I'm slipping and saying something negative, I step away. So you have to ask yourself, which part of myself needs to be improved? Cultivate positive thoughts so that negative thoughts can be pushed away. The seventh thing is they don't worry about failure. Failure doesn't exist in the mind of a successful person. Failure doesn't exist until you've completely given up on something. These people have failed more times than you. And yet they have succeeded. Success is just outlasting everyone in your industry because most people will give up along the way. Most of your competitors will give up, and I guarantee that. So if you just don't stop, eventually you will acquire the skills, acquire the knowledge, and everything you need to be more successful than everyone else out there. If you make the decision in your head, no matter what happens, no matter how many times you fall, no matter how many times you think negative, no matter how many times you fail. The only difference is that millionaires don't allow their failures to hinder the success that is to come. They don't allow their failures to stop them from following the path they're on. The destination remains the same. They just keep going. Sometimes people don't achieve success in life because they're afraid of failure. That way they never try anything. That's the secret formula of failure, doing nothing. Look how interesting. People don't try for fear of failing and do nothing. And because they do nothing, they end up failing. Let me know if you made it to the end of this video. Comment like this. The secret of success is to keep moving forward from failure to failure without losing enthusiasm. When I see this comment, I'll give you a little heart, because I know you are someone who really wants to succeed in life. And to further improve your learning, I'll leave on your screen now two videos that will guide you on how to get out of poverty and become rich in a few months. Click on one of them and go watch it now.